I'll be showing an end-to-end demo of the new Classwork in Teams for Education. Classwork lets educators organize everything that they want into modules, content, curriculum, and then publish it out to students who can then work on it. Okay, so I'm here in a class team, and on the left-hand side, you'll see this new Classwork, and I'm signed in as an educator. I'm going to click on Classwork. What you see is I've already created a couple of modules in my chemistry class, Introduction to Chemistry and Atomic Structure and the Periodic Table. I'll expand this just to show what it looks like. I have a set of different pieces of content here that I've organized. I've got a video, I've got a pointer to a channel, Word documents, OneNote pages, links to sites, everything that you might need. Atomic structure, I'll expand this. Similarly, you can see all of this is organized in just the way that I want. If I want to also drag and drop, it's really easy to reorder these pieces of content within a module. Maybe I want to pull the OneNote page a little bit higher, or maybe I want to put the channel right here. So really easy to drag and drop. Also over on the right, there's a three-dot menu. I can open this, I can download it, I can edit the display name, move it to a different module, or delete it. So lots of different options. The other thing to note is that when you build a new module, which I'll do in just a moment, it doesn't publish it to the class until you're ready. So if you want to have everything prepped, you can do that and leave it in a draft state, and then publish it when you're ready. I'll also show how you can pin modules to the top and make it really easy for the class to find the module that they want to work on. Now, as an educator, we're going to create a brand new module here. So at the bottom, I will click Add Module. I'm going to give that a name. Chemical Bonding and Reactions. Let's give it a description. There's my description. Now I can do things like bold and underline and highlight, even put links in here, so you can make the description as rich and interesting as you'd like. Now I'm going to go click Save. There's my draft module, and you can see right here it says draft state. Now the first thing you want to do is add resources, or you could drop files, but we're going to click the plus to add resources. And you have many options. We're going to start out with something simple. We're going to add a file, and I'm going to choose a file that I already have in my OneDrive. So click OneDrive. I'll go into my chemistry folder, and I'll add the chemical bonds handout and click attach. And it adds that Word document right there. You can also add new files. So maybe I'll click plus here and I will choose file and choose new file. For example, if I want to give a video intro to my class, I can add a video recording. So I'll click that there and choose next. Here's our video recorder. I will click this to record, get a countdown. Hey class, even though Breaking Bad showed a lot of bad things chemistry teachers do, our class for chemistry is going to be amazing. Okay, hit next.
Hey class, even though Breaking Bad
should have... So there is my video. Click next, give it a title. Breaking Bad chemistry intro, hit upload, and then done. Now if I went on drag drop, I can just put this at the top, so I will click on this and drag up, and it easily reorders that. Let's go back up to plus. You can also add assignments, so I'll click here. You can add from a class, you can add a new assignment, you can add a new quiz, or you can create from existing assignments. So if you have assignments in the past, you can easily pull them in. I'm going to choose add from this class. So there's my assignments. I'm going to choose chemical reactions lab and attach that into here. Now I've got that assignment that I've already set the grading categories on and the weightings. So that is assignment that's been added. Go plus again. Now class notebook, one of my favorites. You can add an existing page or a new page. I'm going to choose an existing page here. I've already set up my class notebook here. I will click Content Library, and I will add Chemical Bonding and Reactions. And then we'll go and choose this page right here and attach. Now I've added my Chemical Reactions OneNote page. Let's click plus again. You can even point to different channels. So if you have different channels, over on the left you see I have a couple different channels here. I'm going to point to a channel, and then I'm going to choose Chemical Bonding and Reactions and hit attach. Now this will take them right to a channel. So if you have a lot of content or discussion in that channel, you can have that. And lastly, I'm going to add just a link to a site. So I'll click plus and choose link. I'll add a link to a Khan Academy YouTube video. There's the Khan Academy link, and there's the text to display it. Automatically picks that up. You can even include the thumbnail in it. I'll hit attach. And there's my Khan Academy video. And again, maybe I want to reorder this. I will drag this, put that right there. So now my module is all set up. And note that it's still in draft. I have not published it. And also there's a couple options you have here. So if I hit the three-dot menu, I can edit the name of the module or delete it. Right now, we'll just leave it as it is. Now I'm going to publish this module. So let's hit publish. You get a confirmation, the module and all active resources will be made visible to students, and you cannot hide it after you publish it, but you can still edit or delete it after the fact. So let's hit publish. And it's publishing. Okay, all done, as easy as that. One other thing I will add, in the near future, in the next coming months, so probably in early fall of 2023, we're going to be adding the ability for educators to reuse their modules. So one semester, you might have a set of modules that are structured in a certain way. We're gonna let you pull that same structure in to reuse those modules and save an enormous amount of time for educators. One more thing I'll show before we switch over to the student. You can pin this module to the top or any other module. So if I go to the three-dot menu here, I can now say pin module. And if I pin that, what happens is, see how it says pinned up at the top? So maybe you're going to a specific module in the middle of the semester and you want all the students to focus on that. Now that is going to be pinned when the student signs in. You can see right here, the other modules are lower. You can pin any module. So if you want to swap out, I say pin here, and it puts the atomic structure as the pinned one. But I'm going to go and choose chemical bonding and reactions as the pinned module. That's up at the top. Now I'm going to switch over to the student and show what they see. I'm signed in as the student now, and over on the left, I will choose classwork from my account. Classwork loads up, and hey, there is the pinned chemical bonding and reactions module. It also gives a nice little summary. There's one assignment, one notebook page, two files, one link, and one channel. And I can expand this. Here are all the different parts that my educator added, including the video, the Word document, the assignment, Khan Academy link, OneNote page, and a pointer to a channel. So I can go and start working through this module just in the way that my educator wanted. Classwork is also supported on iOS and Android, so I'm going to switch over to my iPhone to briefly show what the student experience is on Classwork. Here I am. I'm going to choose my chemistry class. Now I'm going to go to the top and choose the new Classwork app to drill in. There are my three modules. I can expand one. There's my chemical bonding and reactions. I can launch the video right there at the top.
Hey class, even though breaking...
Pretty nice. Switch back. So everything you need is right there. All the modules.